Okay, it's July 29th, 2015. It's 5:30 p.m. It's about 98 degrees out here. A storm's coming out the northwest. I did a video earlier, but I had some things on there I didn't want on, and we'll come back out here. Look at how the brown spot is like decimating everything here. I can't see the video because the crack on my viewfinder prevents me from really seeing it, plus the reflection from out here in the sun. But if you look at some of them leaves, they're all like all shriveled up. I was cutting them off, and look how much I took off almost the entire half of this tomato plant. This is the one I started inside the house. Look at this one even from the brown spot. If you look at a video from like 3 days ago even, you can see this was all green. But this brown spot's taking over. Look at this. These four right here are from Kmart. But look at that. Look at how it's destroying that. Okay, it's even getting onto the beans over there. So it's not just the tomatoes. The brown spot. And I don't know how I can stop it. I don't know what to do. But this is heirloom, so what I've been using is just baking soda and water, because that's natural, no chemicals, and it's worked. I've done it for the zucchini before, and they kept coming back. I sprayed all of these like here, cucumbers, sprayed all this before. I haven't sprayed these since the last 2 weeks. Before this, I sprayed this yesterday. See how green the zucchini is here, the leaves? That's after they were looking like this right here. And I spray with that baking soda water mix, and then they start coming back. We see them getting insect eggs on the leaves, you can see. Gosh, it's in the middle of the summer here in the heat. Even these, look at the brown spot. Look at it, look at it, look at it. And I'm blaming it on Fukushima and on the chemtrail spraying they've been doing for the last 35 years or better. But look at the trees here. Be able to see the brown spot on these trees, on the leaves here. I'm not gonna walk all the way back there, but I did on an earlier video. See all the brown spot? See right here? It's on this tree, it's on this tree. Look at the sunflowers. It might be just in the season, but they're all wilted over. I mean, there's a few of those that I planted those tall ones about 6 or 7 weeks after I planted all the others. And they seem like they're doing okay, different type of sunflower. But all my heirloom sunflowers, the double-faced ones and everything else, that's on another one that's got something about Fukushima in the title. But look at how these are all. It's like they're dying off. It's this tree, it's that tree right there. The one on the edge of the property, this one right here, 2, 3, 4, that one 5, that giant pecan tree. If you look on the video before this one, like I said, you'll see brown spots on the leaves like this here. It's one thing to have it on a few leaves, a couple leaves or a branch or two. This is all over the trees. Now, other than chemtrails and Fukushima, someone tell me why they're all getting this brown spot. Look at my garden now. 3 days ago, 4 days ago, the tomatoes looked healthy as hell. You see it on earlier videos. Everything out here was really good. And then I just happened to notice the brown on the tomatoes yesterday. And look at that, in 2 days, how much it's decimated those tomatoes. It's on my beans here. Getting on to the squash. It's all over the sunflowers. Those tomatoes are in full sun for about almost 10 hours out of the day, at least. It's on the beans now. It's on the zucchini a little bit. It's on my cucumbers. It's on the peppers, it's on the tomatoes, and on these beans. So again, you tell me what's causing that brown spot. This is the way they came from Kmart, these four right here. They had hookworms on them, hornworms on them, I believe, because I got four off of those two plants. That are actually the first one and the third one. Now the third and fourth plants are just about ate up from the brown spot. Like I say, you see them on the last two back there are bean plants. I spray them with the water, baking soda mix, and it'll turn them, it'll kill off the bacteria, and you'll have fresh growth like this right here. See, see the bottom leaves down there, how they look? See that? And I sprayed these, I pour a little bit into the ground around the base of the plant, and then it starts coming up green. And I've done that on all these out here, but like I said, these tomatoes are gone just about. Look at that, that one right there, that's what really is pissing me off. That's one I started out inside the house, so small. And it was small, it was half the size of this one right here. And even that one, like I say, 3 days ago, 2 days ago, looked nice and green and full, and now look at it. It's a brown spot, and I am blaming Fukushima and chemtrails, because what else is there to blame? Look at that stuff up there. Those are chemtrails, remnants of chemtrail. There's clouds up there that is not a blue sky. It's a shade of blue, but it's not the blue sky. See that right there, looks like smoke. That's chemtrail. Right above the top of the tree there, that's chemtrail mixed in with the cloud. So this is like the frog in the boiling water pan, okay? Slowly but surely, you're gonna get used to that, and you're just gonna say nothing of it, and you'll say something, and they'll say, oh, well, we'll check into it, and then they don't, and you keep just saying, oh, well, it's no big deal. And in about another, if it goes now, and I do mean if, it goes 3 to 4 years, 5 years, you start having all these upper respiratory infections, and you're coughing up blood, and you wonder why. Look at my videos on chemtrails. There's a lot of swearing, but you know what? If the use of my words offends you that much, and you don't give a shit about these people poisoning your ass, perhaps you need to die. I believe that has a direct effect on my plants out here. Because 3 days ago, 2 days ago, these things were all healthy, everything. Look at that, even that Swiss chard. It slowly withers a little bit, a leaf or two, and it comes back. And now it's all, got all that brown leaves on it, man. I'm telling you, it's the chemtrails, and it's perhaps, who knows, I don't have a Geiger counter. I wish I did have a Geiger counter. Because it's possibly that there's radiation out here. I don't know. You seen the sunflowers, earlier videos, the Fukushima disease sunflowers. So, I got hummers out here on my torch sunflowers, butterflies too. Next year those will be all around the garden, if we have a garden, if we can have a garden, depending on what the mafia decides. So, like I said, they're trying to poison us. And I guess maybe most of you deserve to die. I don't deserve to die. I'm trying to do what little bit I can do. I can videotape the results of what's going on around me and try to get on the internet thinking somebody who has got some weight, some pull, some know-how, the logistics or whatever, could do something. Take my videos and share them. But I don't see that happening either, so I guess you all just want to die. You know, if those could be healthy 3 days ago and now they look like they're on the deathbed, think about you in about 5 years if it goes that far. I don't see it going that far, not with what's going on with the illegal guy in the White House. And he is illegal, and that's one of the things they're trying to keep quiet, because they don't want no civil unrest, that type of civil unrest, at least not yet. They might release that pretty soon, and then all hell will break loose. It will be hell on earth. And like I said, I've been trying to tell you guys for probably almost 10 years. I had another account, I had to delete all my videos. I swear on all of them, because they're trying to murder you. And you're too fucking stupid to understand that. Those aren't clouds. That's chemtrails. That's not clouds. That's chemtrails. See how it just mixes in? It comes down and starts to mix in with the clouds. Go outside and take some deep breaths. Maybe you'll be gone a lot sooner than I am, so we don't have to worry about the stupidity on this planet. But look at the trees now. Look at the top. It's they got disease just like they have in the past. Black walnuts is one of the healthiest walnuts you could have. It's very good for you. This used to be very rich for black walnuts down here. About 20 years ago, all of a sudden, a disease come in there and they wiped out. They killed every tree. They just tore them all down, whether they were sick or not. So this is just another phase. Nothing's being done. Everybody wants to sit with their thumb up their ass. So take it out and suck it for a while.